Monitoring is an essential part of any fruit fly management program. Monitoring for Queensland fruit fly, or Q-fly, involves traps baited with the male attractant Q-lure and an insecticide. There are a number of different traps available for monitoring. Two of the newer ones are a bio trap and a cone trap. The cone trap comes flat packed. It's quite easy to assemble. This is one I made earlier. You just pop in the sachet of male attractant Q-lure without blocking the holes and then put on the lid. The lid has already been treated with insecticide, so it's easy to use. Now it's ready to hang in the tree. For the bio trap, you're going to need gloves on. In this case, both the Q-lure and the insecticide are on this wax wafer. This is assembled by hooking it over the little plastic device inside the trap. Once it's attached, you just clip on the base and it's ready to hang. Areas with native vegetation, especially if there's a creek line, are a great habitat for fruit flies and a potential source of infestation of your crop. So it's a good idea to put a trap to monitor numbers in those areas, just to see what's going on. If there's an orchard area adjoining your crop, then that's another good place to put a monitoring trap. Otherwise, trees and other vegetation around the perimeter of the crop are the best place to put monitoring traps. In cool climate areas, hang the traps on the northern side of the trees. As flies tend to prefer warm spots, especially at dusk. In hot areas, it's better to hang them on the eastern side. Traps should not be spaced more than 400 metres apart, so it may be useful to put some within the crop itself. As you're putting the traps out, be sure to mark them on your farm map. That way anyone else can go and check them and record how many flies are in each one. Traps should be monitored regularly, especially if daytime temperatures are over 20 degrees. Simply count the number of flies in the trap and record it on a data sheet with the date and the trap location. Don't forget to throw out any dead flies before resetting the trap. It's important to remember that trap numbers don't actually tell you how many flies are in the crop or whether they're laying eggs. They just tell you whether flies are there and whether their numbers are increasing or decreasing.